Today's video is to answer a simple question that was asked by a viewer some time ago. How would you differentiate between curly B lines and blood vessels? Well, yes, the answer can be difficult if you don't know a few things, but if you do, it is something very, very easy. Curly B lines are horizontal or almost horizontal lines that start from pleura. They travel towards the hilum. They have maximum 2 cm in length and 2 mm in diameter, and they are mostly visible in costophrenic angles here and on the other side. They become smaller as they move towards the hilum, and they become invisible after 2 cm. Versus the blood vessels, they are the widest in the hilum, and as they branch off and they move, as they move towards the lateral chest wall, they become smaller and smaller, and in fact towards the chest wall they become so thin that they're not visible on a normal chest x-ray. Curly B lines are actually distended interlobular septae, and the cause of distension is mostly fluid, as in case of left heart failure. The x-ray is a very good example that is showing all radiological features of increased pulmonary venous pressure. And I'll give you a few seconds if you can point out some of the features of acute left heart failure. Well, perihilar haze is the first sign. The blood vessels in the hilar region are not clearly defined. On a normal chest x-ray, you should be able to draw an outline of all major vessels that are entering into the lung, which is clearly not possible in this case. The second feature is the prominence of upper lobe vessels. The upper lobe vessels have become actually bigger than the lower lobe vessels, and they are much clearly visible in this area and in this area as compared to the lower zones. And the third sign is the presence of interstitial edema, which is confirmed by the presence of curly B lines. As I said before, curly B lines are usually visible in costophrenic angles. This is a very rare example where you can still see the curly B lines in upper to mid zones. And if an x-ray was taken few minutes later, the interstitial edema will show up as alveolar space opacities. You can see pleural effusion when lymphatics find it difficult to cope with the excess fluid that is coming into the interstitium as well as into the alveolar spaces. This is a pacemaker, and you can see pacing leads within the heart. Okay, our normal chest x-ray once again for reference, and to see the difference, you can see the perihilar vessels are clearly defined. The lower lobe vessels are bigger than the upper lobe vessels, and in fact you can actually make an outline if you had a pencil, and if you wanted to, you can actually make an outline of all the major vessels that are visible. The lateral chest wall, there are no linear, there are no horizontal opacities on the lateral chest wall. In fact, there are no vascular markings visible in this area or in this area. Thank you very much.